clear. Here off of Highway 23. Come in one of these weird positions where you don't know what to do because your situation is somewhat unknown. The road is closed south of this exit. There's just a detour sign. You have no idea where that detour sign's going, what it's going to lead to, if the road's even legal to drive on. You can see the road, it's all polka dotted because it's closed. So we're just going to follow the detour sign and hope for the best. Good route, per se, to take. So it's kind of a guess and a gamble at this point. I hate when they do this, man. I seen traffic coming from the other way, but it was all car, automobile traffic, you know. I didn't see any semis in that, so cars might know a better way, but you might not be able to go in there. There goes a semi right there, so I'm guessing he's gonna follow the marked detour. And it's really not well marked, it's just a sign at the end of the ramp that says detour. And if somebody is sitting there, you're not gonna see it. Better. the one that usually gives you real good exhaust note. I see from the last video that I uploaded that the audio doesn't come out that good with the aftermarket mic on the back of the truck. It picks up more wind noise than exhaust. It kind of hollows it out. Doesn't sound so good. So we're gonna just keep the bike on the inside. I got the one GoPro on the back of the truck, on the generator facing forward, obviously. Shut that right down. I guess that was a good way to go. See a lot of skid marks on that intersection there. Sounded good though. Why do I think this is gonna snake trail us all the way over to 94? This is one of those closures where when you're coming north of Ann Arbor, south on 23, you thought you seen a sign but wasn't sure if you missed it, because it just shows on the electric sign. But you didn't see if it gave you the times of day that they were gonna shut the road down, so you keep going. Then you get closer and closer and you look and find out, crap, there isn't an alternate road. It'll tell you like, US 23 closed at Plank Road, seek alternate route. Okay, number one, I'm not from here. What exit is Plank Road? Number one. Number two, like I know an alternate route? And what would be the legal alternate route? Can I make this right turn? Well, he's gonna try it. Obviously I can, I seen the sign and had a weight restriction. What would he do? I think that car just drove off the road partway. I think he bumped it right in that little section there. Challenger just turned off. Well, I can remember years ago I was trying to send something out in the mail to somebody down in Louisiana, lived in took me fishing down there years ago. I was trying to send a cell phone of all things. Anyway, I remember I was coming through here trying to, not here, but a road like this in the daytime, trying to get through so I can make it to a post office so I can package up the cell phone and send it to Louisiana. And then like, I don't know, it was like 3 weeks later, I just happened to finally get down there. That was weird. Scheduling wise, you know. I remember that trip. There I am in the parking lot of a Petro, I think. No, a TA. Now, who knows what it is now? Heck, it could be gone. It was... Anyway, trying to put a sector shaft U-joint in a Peterbilt in a parking lot. Thank you. detour sign that says keep going straight. How many miles? Been a while. Gotta love. love me. We're literally back at the Loves. We're just like a mile or couple north of the Loves. That driver up there in front of me, I don't know if you hear me or not. We literally just did a big circle. Back at 23. And that's the Loves we just left. We just drove around in circles for 40 friggin' minutes. All right, so now I gotta figure out the damn routing. We are here. We go west, cut down on this road, Wabash, make a left on a Wabash and stay on it. That runs us perpendicular to the road. When we get to the end of Cone Road, it looks like it's closed to the highway, so we have to make a left on Cone, and then we basically head to the next bigger road, which shows decent size, which is, I want to make it smaller, Denison Road. Make a left on Denison and follow that down till you get to Route 50. That's the basic route guidance. So what I'll do, we're gonna drop a pin at Denison and Route 50, and it make Google Maps find me. It wouldn't let us do that. Remember that left it wouldn't let us do? So that's the basic plan. I can't believe that, man. That's insane. I've seen some crap. I've seen some crap, but never like that. That detour is bogus. Well, that's the route we're taking, so. If it ain't a legal road, then so be it. No, I tried. I got video evidence of it, too. Try to clean the windows for you guys a little bit. Scrub them with the, you know, piss water that's sitting outside the loves. And then gave them a rinse with my windshield bug remover. Ooh, that is a nice car for a truck stop. Lexus FLA. Yeah, lady, you're in the wrong parking lot. Take a truck, be careful. That detour really ain't a detour. It's gonna circle you back. It'll take you an hour and you'll wind up on exit north. Wasn't a chicken truck anyway, it was a covered wagon. Come on, pizza boy, let's go. That's got to be northbound coming up. All that traffic all of a sudden coming the other way. That's got to be northbounders trying to get to there around there for the AC detour. Sorry guys, this is probably the darkest video I've ever done. Because so far, got an hour of film, and it's all been night. Trucks, no right turn. Thanks, butthole. Hard enough to make a left. If it is, you can come pull me over. Good job, Arnell.
Man, you made that look good.
There, looks like.